So let's talk about NordVPN. You've probably already heard of them at this point in time, thanks to what you just saw. This is going to be our much needed update review of the service as of August 2020, and we're going to answer the question, is Nord a good VPN in 2020? And that's a complex question considering their size and controversies, which we will cover. Today, we'll be updating the NordVPN review using our systematic review protocol on version 3.0.1 based on six categories prioritized by percentage for a total score out of five. We keep everything systematic and public, so you can view all of this on GitHub. And the coolest thing is if you don't agree with our criteria and or scoring methods, just switch out the values along the way. Let's go ahead and dive into the security of NordVPN. To start with history, Nord's private keys were leaked, granting a hacker access to a server in Finland. This also affected Torgard and Viking VPN. There's actually a lot of drama behind this. In short, though, in terms of Nord, Nord screwed up, they didn't publicize it for several months, and they downplayed the severity of the issue. They eventually came around and addressed it and took a lot of precautions since then, including terminating the contract with the affected server rental company, getting their entire infrastructure audited, moving to diskless servers, and introducing a bug bounty program. It's unclear if this actually affected customers. Aside from this, there was a payment bug that could have leaked customer data, and this was discovered in a safe environment, so this was safe, but still revealed a potential security problem. There was also a credential stuffing attack that may have affected users with weak and reused passwords. This is not strictly Nord's fault, it's predominantly the user's fault for using reused, weak passwords. Nord, though, could have been more proactive to prevent the situation by warning users about weak passwords. The source covers this more thoroughly. Security history, we took off half because of their original poor response to things, but as of today, it doesn't seem any customers were affected, and Nord did respond to most of these situations, but these are still valid concerns that deserve to be reflected in the scoring. Nord passes pretty much everything else in security, like most services. They have OpenVPN and WireGuard, they pass their basic security tests, and they checked the rest off, except for two things. One, no two-factor authentication. This would have prevented their credential stuffing issue, as well as the apparent black market of stolen NordVPN accounts. The last ding to their security score is misleading marketing, as Nord is known to offer never-ending deals with fake timers. I swear their birthday lasted for weeks. It's called a birthday, Nord, not a birth week or birth month, birthday. The final security score was 4.15 out of 5, which sounds good until you realize that's the third lowest security score of any service we've tested. Let's move to privacy. Kind of like security, there is some controversy in their history. There is the Tessonet drama, an accusation that NordVPN is owned by a data mining company called Tessonet. I've already addressed this in another video summarizing the whole issue. Some people really don't like this, and I agree, it's a bit odd to have so many different entities working on different things in different countries. However, there's no proof of abuse. It just could be that. A marketing division from Tessonet, a payment division through Tefencom, and yeah, that's how we have to take it. The only other major thing that's a red flag is their Wayback Machine is totally excluded from results, which is odd. But again, that doesn't directly prove or impact any issues with privacy. What severely impacts privacy is things like analytics being enabled by default, as well as an email sharing issue, which we'll cover soon. These issues have lost them all points for their previous history in relation to privacy. Outside of history, though, Nord implements generally good stuff. They have a no-logs policy that's been independently audited, first-party DNS servers, jurisdiction outside of the 14 eyes, a warrant canary, and a simple private payment method. Where they lost some points is first, requiring an email. You can fake this, but we still deduct for the requirement. Like we said, they do implement misleading marketing. And finally, this is, in our opinion, the largest privacy concern with Nord as of today. They implement trackers both on their website and within their Android application and likely others. You're looking at a company advocating for privacy and protecting you from internet trackers and whatever else they claim through their marketing that implements Google within their website and their apps. It warns you that it is on, but it doesn't ask you if you want it to be on. You have to go into the settings and disable it. Another layer to this is a researcher accused Nord of submitting the emails of their users through these analytics tools, which is a big no, and they lost all points for tracking concerns and their history because of these things. The final privacy score came out to 3.3 out of 5. The main hits were the questionable history and the trackers. To give some context, in our old review, privacy and security used to be the same category, and they used to be 5 out of 5. So for them to be nailed this hard in both security and privacy in 2020 is a huge shift in the company, and we're going to talk more about this all towards the end. This is our fourth Nord update, and every single time they have absolutely slaughtered speed results. We're looking at within a 5% drop off in almost every test universally with utmost consistency. It's that simple. These are my speed results in my location, so understand this isn't representative of everybody. Our speed team is currently being revamped. We covered this in our channel update, but once it's back live, we intend to speed test Nord with speed team V3. The speeds more than met the minimum requirements for a perfect speed score. It doesn't get much better than that. Settings for Nord has always been a weak spot. We'll talk more about its user experience in the next category, but in short, it's designed to be simple. You will find most of what you need, but that's it. Setting scoring is up to the individual, so again, check out the protocol and adjust scoring as you please. We deduct though for this, and they just barely beat out where they were a couple years ago because of a couple new settings across their clients, like Nord links, some extra settings on mobile clients, and minor updates to desktop. So 3.5 out of 5, just a slight improvement from last time around, but really not that different. The usage and user experience. This really is where Nord shines. To this day, the whole ecosystem of using Nord it's beyond polished and just well done. It's hard for me to even poke holes in it. It's just a polished service, from the marketing, to the clients, to the site, everything. And we'll talk about that later on and why it's good and bad, but for now, we're just covering the usage. Windows and Mac OS has barely changed since I last looked at them. Seriously, this is the same client outside the settings panel and the inclusion of just a couple more settings like Nord links, which is their version of WireGuard, a faster VPN protocol than OpenVPN, and they finally, introduced more specific location settings. Regardless of the lack of changes, it's still a pleasure using these clients. They really are, to this day, still some of my favorite clients to use. Over to Linux though, just like years ago, I'm still disappointed. Nord didn't have a CLI in our last review, and they did introduce a command line tool. It is one of the better CLIs I've used, but ideally there should be a GUI offering, especially for a company that aims for a polished ecosystem. Additionally, they are officially behind in 2020. It's not just AirVPN's Eddy client that lives on Linux. We have PIA, Mulvad, TorGuard, even AstralVPN. That's right, AstralVPN has one. And Windscribe 2.0 is going to be a Linux GUI, whenever that decides to come out. Come on, Jaeger, come on. Mobile clients, as always, are great. The UI and experience has changed over the years, but I'd say overall for the better. I really did enjoy both the iOS and Android apps. I think they've really improved over time, and they both have great reviews on both stores. Speed consistency, again, is incredibly strong. Their auto-connect on every client worked perfectly for me, and Nord is open to torrenting and doesn't censor traffic. To summarize usage, it really is a great experience. Even people who dislike Nord and don't trust it, which is fair, seem to at least agree the user experience is solid. Their lack of a Linux GUI took off half a point from their score, which is a universal thing we do, so they earned 4.5 out of 5. And finally, stability. I am proud to report stability seems to have been fixed since the last review. The main complaint back then was this ridiculous waiting period for the VPN to connect, upwards of 15 to 20 seconds and sometimes more, and that is now fixed, thank goodness, and there was nothing else to complain about outside of that. And here's the additional address section, which doesn't impact scoring, and we're gonna go through this ASAP. Nord allows 6 simultaneous devices. They have split tunneling on Android, multi-hop servers, a huge server selection of over 5,000 servers in about 60 countries. That is top notch. The current lowest price advertised is about $4 a month for a year. They have a 30-day money-back guarantee, which is legit, and they do help some causes, which is nice. Although I wish they benefited like the EFF and other organizations, but yeah, we'll take it, we'll take it. Lastly, if you couldn't already tell, we would give this a beginner label. It's very, very simple to use with no extra fluff, if that's what you prefer. The final score for NordVPN ended up being 4.24 out of 5, which is good, not great. That's currently number 8 of the services we've reviewed out of 21. To reflect, the user experience of Nord is just top notch. You will likely enjoy using it. However, I don't think it's a great service for your privacy in this day and age. Nord has grown so large and has been targeted by attacks, scandals, and other things in between that has lost trust over the years, but they have such a great and polished experience that it's easy to forget what's happening underneath. I find it almost symbolic that you're gonna open such a beautiful client only to discover that it by default enables tracking with no opt-in during setup. Yeah. That's kind of the art major speaking out. But yes, at the end of the day for privacy, you have better options. Take a look at our VPN chart. You have services who are performing audits on fully open source applications, so you can look over the code of the software yourself. and these companies have a much cleaner and reputable history of valuing user privacy and security. If you want to see what some of these services are, I'd recommend watching our top 5 best services of 2020, as all services there are for the most part strong privacy-wise. My last comment to make, and this is mostly to Nord if they watch this, okay? Let's be real. It's clear you guys put a ton of money into marketing. You have the funds. Please prioritize privacy by default for your users. Implement two-factor authentication. Get a Linux GUI. Just please. I've been calling for the latter two things for years now, and they're still non-existent in 2020, which is even worse considering other VPNs now have them. Nord has slipped off of our top spot, and I think it's a lack of priorities, and at least what we consider the priorities, and I don't know if they're going to earn that back. So yeah, work with that. And that is the review. Nord did score well enough to meet our affiliate requirements, which you can read on GitHub. We would really appreciate if you do want to go with Nord to sign up using our link before buying it to support us in doing standardized and transparent VPN reviews. We also have a normal link down there as well, so no pressure, that is fully your choice. Thank you for watching again. If you want to see our most up-to-date top 5 VPNs video, check it out in the description. We are updating PIA and ExpressVPN soon as well. After also several years, we are very behind, so subscribe to catch those. Don't forget to like and share this video if you liked it. Join our awesome communities, and finally, don't forget to have a great rest of your day. It's burning here in California, so I'm working with it here.
Just walking in a normal day, and I look up, ooh, oh, oh, wow, whoa.